Hey everyone, in this video I wanted to walk through a little solution I threw together pretty quickly that enabled me to bulk stop and start all the resources in my Azure subscription, but would stop and start them in a certain order because maybe I had domain controllers that I wanted to make sure always started first but also stopped last, and then maybe some dependent services like a directory sync that would start after the domain controllers, etc., etc. So the way I thought about this is if I had my subscription, within that subscription, there were various resources. And the ones that I wanted in scope, I would add a tag called priority, and then I would give it a value. Now, the lower the number, the higher the priority. So obviously one would be the highest, two, three, four, etc. And I did it in 100 increments. So maybe it's a priority 100. Some others had a priority of 200. And the way I would do this is I would start the hundreds first, then wait 2 minutes, then start the next batch, etc., etc. So you would go and give all of the resources you wanted to basically be in scope a priority. So if I go and look at my subscription, if I quickly was to look, for example, at my virtual machines, I would look at this domain controller, and for my tags, you can see here, well, I have a priority of 100. So this would start first and stop last. But my directory sync box, well, that has a priority of 200. So it would start after the batch of domain controllers. And then I've got just a regular, like a SQL VM, well, that's a priority of 300. And what's in scope initially for me was just VMs, VM scale sets, and AKS clusters. So then I have a Kubernetes cluster, and it I want to start last and stop first, so it has a priority of 300. So the way we light this up was actually just using Resource Graph. So if I actually jump over to Resource Graph super, super quickly, it's pretty easy to just look at resources of that type. So here, this query just looks at anything that is a compute provider VM or a VM scale set, and then the container service and managed cluster. So if I was to just run this query, I'll get a list of all these various resources. But what I wanted was to only focus on the ones that had a priority set. Now I have this priority tag, and so what I wanted to do is obviously expand out the tags. Now, from this, what I could actually do is in between this project, I can add in, well, let's expand out the tags. So then you'll get an entry for each tag it has, but they're not super useful to use. So then we'll actually extend the values to create a tag key and a tag value, actual element. And I would see that as it goes through the details, I'll see more of those shown to me actually from there. But what I actually then wanted was to only focus on making my tag key that priority. So I'll change my tag key to there. So I want it where the tag key is priority, ignore all the others. So now I'll only see those. And I want to project out now my tag key and my tag value. So now suddenly it's a lot more useful. The output is now only outputting the entries which have a tag called priority and what is that priority value. And then if I'm starting them, what I would do is I would order them ascending. So it's going to show me, hey, the 100, then the 200, then the 300, etc. If I was stopping them, then I would order it by descending, which would then let me, hey, the ones with the lowest priority would show first, so I would stop those first. So that's all this is doing. So I would set the priority, and then I use this query in the resource graph to list them out, either ascending or descending. I'm just going to use a function app to do this. So if we jumped over to our function apps, just create a new function app. Now I've already created this, start all my stuff. There's a few things we want to do in the function app. Now, I want to use the AZ resource graph. Now, ordinarily, I would look at my app files, and from app files, we have requirements. Now, we're going to uncomment the AZ line because I want to be able to use the AZ PowerShell module. But for me, trying to add in the AZ resource graph did not work. I think because it's in preview. And so instead, what we do is we basically copy in the module for the AZ resource graph into our project. If we go down and look at our advanced tools, one of the things this gives us the ability to do is import a zip file. And so completely separate from this, if we go to our tools, zip push deploy, you can just drag a zip file into here. And so completely separate from this, all you have to do is create a folder with that module inside it. It makes it very, very easy to do just by saving it. So if I was to bring up a console super quickly, if I'm in a trash folder right now, and if we look, this trash folder is empty. And all I have to do is actually just make a directory modules. So it's now got an empty directory modules. And if I just say save module az.resourceGraph to that modules folder, it will download it from the repository and save it into that folder. And then all I would have to do is take that folder and zip it up. So now if I look, I've got the modules and it's saved inside there, resource graph, and there's the version. I don't need the accounts, so I'll just kill that, delete it. And then I would just zip this. So I would compress to a zip file. It will now give me the modules.zip, and I would now just drag that into that folder. And what I would end up with is this. So I want to see a modules folder in my WW root, which is the root of my function app. And you'll see in mine, it's got that AZ resource graph with that version with the files inside it. And that's it. That's all I had to do. If it went to the wrong place, obviously you can just open up a console. So I could open up a PowerShell console and I could copy it and move it around however I needed to. But the net result is that modules folder is there in my environment. So the next thing I would want to do is within here in these app files, a function, if it's the free one, which is all I'm using, by default is 5 minute timeout. Now you can increase that to 10 minutes for the free one. So in my host.json, I'm changing the function timeout to 10 minutes. So I want to have a wait between each of the batches of priorities. And so I want to make it as long as possible. If you want more increments, I could obviously move to a more app service plan that I pay for, and then I could make this a longer duration. But for me, 10 minutes was plenty. I've already, remember, uncommented out the AZ. But now what I want is in my profile, so this is going to load every time the function runs. I want to import in that AZ resource graph. So I'm adding in that line. That is another thing I want to do. If I look at my code solution, I have a function. And this function is not super powerful, but it gets passed a couple of parameters. It's a command it wants to run. It's the type of resource, so a VM, a VMSS, an AKS. Is it stopping or starting? And then the actual name of the resource, just for logging. So I create a function to do that run so I could encapsulate it in a try catch. I could write out the error. I didn't want to have to repeat that multiple times. So this function I need defined. And the way we do that is, well, I take this function and I paste it inside my profile. So if we scroll down, this is where I can define functions or aliases that can be referenced in the function I'm going to create inside this function app. So I pasted that into my profile.ps1. So now that function will be available to any function that I define inside that function app. So we've done those things. We've copied the module. We've created the import. We've created the function we want to call. We've changed the timeout to 10. So all I have to do is go go and create the function. Now, one other thing I do require is, because the functions are going to be stopping and starting resources, they need permissions. I can do that very, very simply. I just need to go and enable the identity. So I used the system assigned managed identity, and then I gave it contributor at the subscription level. Now, that's more permission than is required. You could absolutely be more granular in that. This is just a dev environment I don't really care about. So that was an easy win for me. But you could be more specific. You could create custom role if you wanted to that just had stop and start for each of the types of resources you want. But it does need to be able to use that identity. I don't have to put anything in my code. By default, the profile of the function app that's PowerShell will automatically check, hey, is there a managed identity? And if there is, and I've remember uncommented that line to use as the requirements, the AZ module, it will just authenticate as this managed identity. So I turn this on, and then I just gave it contributor rights at the subscription level. So they just need that so it can run as the identity. So now for mine, they're both timer-based. So hey, I'd want to create a new function, and this function was PowerShell-based, and it's going to be a timer trigger. Now the timer trigger is going to be a cron job. So it's in the cron format, and remember it's UTC unless I change something. So for me, I have to think if it's 5 or 6 hours difference. So I set this to the value when I want my start. And I'm going to create a separate one for when I want it to stop. I can only have one timer trigger per function. So I create two. So if we look at mine, I have a start and a stop. So if I look at my start function, and we look at the integration, and this, we can change it after we create it. I have my timer. So my timer is once a day at 10. Now remember, this is UTC. So for me, I think that's 4 a.m. So 4 a.m. it will start all my resources in Texas. Likewise, if I was to look at my stop, If I was to look at my stop function and look at my integration, well, for my stop, my timer, again, it's UTC, 3 a.m., which is like 10 p.m. So I'm stopping and starting them, save my money. I'm just using those capabilities. And that's really it. So then the code is just, it's the same code for both functions. There are other ways I could have solved this. I could have done it as a separate function and then called that function from other functions. Honestly, I'm being fairly lazy. And so it's the same code in both of them. The code is in the GitHub repo, and I'm just taking the main code. So I'm copying all of this. And you can see all it really does is the first thing you do is you uncomment one of the lines. Am I running it in a start mode or am I running it in a stop mode? So it's the same code, but obviously I uncomment the required line. And then that sets the sorting order, and it sets, is it starting, true or false? And so that sort mode is then used in the here string we create to go and fetch all of the resources. So that's the point. It just uses that sort mode here to do the ascend or descend. And then it runs the query, it finds the lowest priority, and then for each resource, it checks, does the priority change? If the priority changes, then it runs whatever our sleep period is. So for me, I have set my sleep to 2 minutes, but you could change that to whatever you wanted it to be. So in each increment of priority change, it will wait 2 minutes. So my domain controllers have 2 minutes to start before it then goes and start the dir sync box. And then it waits another 2 minutes before it starts the SQL and other VMs in my AKS cluster. And it does the same for the stopping. I could change that interval if I wanted to. It's up to me. But then it's simply for each of those resources, is it starting or stopping? What's the command it needs? And it uses that function we defined in the function app in that profile to get past the command that it has to run, be it a start or stop. The only special thing it does is if it's a virtual machine scale set, it does go and get information to make sure it's not part of an AKS cluster. Because if it's part of an AKS cluster, I shouldn't be stopping and starting the VM scale set directly. Instead, what I should be doing is stopping it via AKS. So it won't stop or start it, it'll error out. Instead, you should be doing that through the AKS, which it handles as well down here. And that's it. It's a really super simple function, but it works. And I've just got those defined inside my stop function and start function. Obviously, my stop, I have the start line commented out, and it's in the mode stop. For my start, it's vice versa. But it's exactly the same code in both of those. And it just starts and stops my functions as I need every day. And that's it. So really the only fun part this might be is a little bit different is that idea of the module and then having that function. And again, the function is defined at the function app level, not the individual function. It's shared by them. And then the app file, hey, I've got that import. I've got that function defined as part of my profile. I could change that timeout. And hey, you can just go and play around with it. So that was it. Just wanted to show a little bit of fun. Maybe it's useful. Obviously, there are other types of resource you can stop and start. I could add in serverless SQL databases or flexible MySQL, or flexible Postgres, all those different things. So you could play around and enhance it to whatever types of resources you want. I may do that in the future. But for now, my priority was VM, VM scale sets, and AKS. And it very simple, but it works. That was it. So until the next video, take care.